The story that's playing out every day on our TV screens and Twitter feeds. He's getting worse. We can all see it. It's happening in public. But it's still a very hard, very sensitive story to cover. I'm talking, of course, about President Trump, about his behavior, about his instability, the contradictions, the lies, the complete rejection of reality. Some prominent figures, including the husband of Trump aide Kellyanne Conway, are pleading with the press to take this more seriously. On Friday, George Conway said Trump is decomposing before our very eyes. He said, quote, Republicans need to face up to the fact that the president is mentally unstable and psychologically unfit. Now, Conway seems to think it's narcissistic personality disorder. Others have other concerns. Anthony Scaramucci is out there saying mental breakdown. What makes them so worried? Well, stuff like this. This summer has been chock full of examples. Trump making racist remarks about Baltimore, making racist comments about the squad, repeating ridiculous claims about voter fraud, denying things you can hear with your own ears, like calling Meghan Markle nasty on tape and then claiming he never said it. He's been bragging about his visits to hospitals in Dayton and El Paso. He did once mix up Dayton and Toledo, two different cities in Ohio. Then there's canceling a planned trip to Denmark over the Greenland dispute. And you remember back in June, he attacked Nancy Pelosi and Robert Mueller while at a World War II cemetery. He's been retweeting conspiracy theories about Jeffrey Epstein. The list goes on and on, but the list is necessary in order to cover the big picture of what's going on. Look, all of these stories are covered in the moment, individually, by reporters. News outlets use words there like erratic, volatile, unstable. But rarely are Trump's words and actions covered as a whole. Rarely do news outlets take it to that next level. Okay, what he just said seems crazy. What does that reveal about him? We rarely see it go to that next step. Now, I get the Trump opponents have been saying he's sick since before Election Day. I think some folks throw out terms like cognitive decline way too casually. They dream about the 25th Amendment. But it is possible to have a fully fact-based conversation about this. In fact, it's not just possible, it's necessary. Look at the New York Times this week reporting that some former Trump aides are, quote, increasingly worried about his behavior. Most people who cover this world for a living know that. I spent the week talking with major media figures at networks and newspapers. There is definitely a widespread recognition that Trump's behavior is getting worse in type and in frequency. It seems he's acting more erratic more often. I mean, calling his Federal Reserve chair an enemy and comparing him to the communist leader of China, sending the markets into a free fall? Come on. Of course, the president is always going to have a choir to back him up, to rationalize the irrational, to make excuses, or to say, hey, he was just kidding. His Fox fans pretend that Trump's worst episodes didn't happen at all, or they, you know, they blame the media for bad coverage. But let's talk about that coverage, everywhere but Fox. When you watch a broadcast nightly newscast, how often do you hear about just how far off the road Trump is? Not often enough. Yes, they do note the daily madness, but they rarely connect the dots between the freakouts. Now, I do think CNN and MSNBC are better about putting the ugly reality right front and center in banners and in stories, but there's not really a vocabulary for this. There's not really a format for covering it. I mean, look, it's comfortable and natural to lead a newscast with, say, Trump wanting to buy Greenland. We have a format for that. We know what to do. We know what to put in the banner. We know how to do it. It's a lot harder to cover concerns about the president's well-being because it's really a series of questions that no one is able to answer. Why does he make it all about himself, even after, for example, visiting a hospital after a massacre? Why does he lie so often? Is there a method to the madness, or is something wrong? Is he suffering from some sort of illness? It's questions, questions, and then just more questions. No satisfying answers. And here's what happens every time. Take Megan McArdle's newest column for The Washington Post. She says, I'm not Trump's doctor, and I don't know what's wrong with him. There's that understandable aversion to diagnosing someone off the TV. And that aversion sometimes shuts down these conversations. But McArdle said she doesn't need a diagnosis to know she should be worried. And maybe that's the point. Here's James Fallows making a similar point for The Atlantic, saying if Trump were a CEO or an airline pilot or in virtually any other position of responsibility, action would already be underway to remove him from that role. So something's wrong. There are lots of theories about what it is. There are some doctors who think they know. There are others who say we shouldn't speculate. There are ethical questions about even having this conversation at all. but we can't tiptoe around it anymore. We've got to talk about this.